This is not just the place where the world's best tech gets unveiled. It's where visionary ideas come to life. Because it's not enough to create amazing things. You have to create things that make a meaningful difference with people. Real people. Because they're the ones who decide what's worth talking about. What's ready for reality. It's tech that allows us to connect and explore and play in ways we can see and ways we haven't begun to imagine. And here, right now, is where we'll discover the ideas that will change our lives for the better. Are you ready?
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Executive Vice President of CES at the Consumer Technology Association, Karen Chupka.
Well, good morning, everybody. And welcome to the second day of CES 2020. I'm so delighted to introduce to you this morning's keynote address. Quibi CEO Meg Whitman and Quibi founder and chairman of the board, Jeffrey Katzenberg. You know, admittedly, these two leaders are so well-known that they almost need no introduction. Meg has served as CEO of Hewlett-Packard Enterprise and president and CEO of the Hewlett-Packard Company, as well as president of CEO and CEO of eBay. In fact, she actually spoke here many, many years ago as part of eBay. And in addition to his role at Quibi, Jeffrey is co-founder and managing partner of Wonder Company. He brings more than 40 years of experience as an entertainment industry leader. He's serving as president of production at Paramount Studios, chairman of the Walt Disney Studios, and as co-founder of DreamWorks SKG, where he served as CEO. And despite their impressive resumes, neither has felt the need to rest on their laurels. And so instead, they've pushed themselves and their companies to new heights of creativity and success. And Quibi is their new adventure, and it's poised to launch in the coming year. It's going to transform short-form premium video, bringing together some of today's most creative directors, actors, and entertainers, all on a mobile platform. We at CTA couldn't be more thrilled to welcome these two visionaries to the CES stage. Their work has pushed the boundaries of the possible opening of our minds to the full extent of human potential. And I'm really eager to hear what they have to say and very confident that their insights are going to resonate with creators and innovators from all different backgrounds and industries. We look forward to welcoming Meg and Jeffrey Katzenberg to the stage in just a few minutes. Thank you.
Storytelling in episodes 4 to 10 minutes in length, so you can watch on the go, wherever you go.
From news to weather to movies and chapters, there is always time for Quibi.
Because it's designed specifically to watch only on your phone.
Where you're in control
of what you watch,
when you watch,
and where you watch.
Only on Quibi.
Whether you portrait or landscape, you were seeing
beautiful full-screen images like you've never seen before.
From world-renowned creators. With a fresh perspective
on how to storytell on the small screen.
It's content meant to be consumed on the go.
It fits into any moment of your day.
Everything you need to know and why it matters.
Only on Quibi.
So be entertained.
Be informed.
Be inspired.
Be delighted.
Be mesmerized.
Be amazed.
Good morning. What's the next big opportunity in entertainment? Well, that's a question I've been asking myself pretty much my whole career. And what you see when you look back at the great technological leaps in entertainment history is that every evolution has been driven by the relationship between creativity and technology. Behind every innovation, we see brilliant minds pushing the limits of science to create new entertainment technology. But these new platforms required the creativity of storytellers using these tools in ways that their inventors had never imagined to amaze audiences. Until the motion picture was invented, theater had to happen in a pretty small box. But when the first minutes of film were shot, suddenly the whole world became a stage. And that new world could be brought to life again in any movie theater. As new features were added to the motion picture platform, sound, color, 3D, and computer animation, they opened new possibilities for creators to delight audiences in ways that their inventors actually had never imagined. Who can forget the moment in The Wizard of Oz when Dorothy opened the door to a world in Technicolor? Decades later, we saw another technological leap, this time with the invention of television. Again, this new technology platform created a huge burst of creative energy. Suddenly, stories didn't have to wrap up in 2 hours. We have whole seasons to spend with characters that we know so well, they feel like family. In some ways, the experience of television became more intimate than movie theaters, bringing families together to watch their favorite programs. But it wasn't until July 1st, 1941, that one of television's most notable features was introduced. On that night, right before the Brooklyn Dodgers played the Philadelphia Phillies, NBC aired a 10-second commercial for Bulova watches. The television commercial defined the medium because it imposed a rigid structure on programs to allow for commercial breaks. But that creative challenge made television creators more disciplined in how they told their stories. Today, we're living through another revolution in entertainment, this time on our mobile phones. Mobile phones are the most widely distributed, democratized entertainment platform the world has ever seen. And innovation in mobile technology and network capability mean that we now have billions of listeners, of users, watching billions of hours of content every single day. And those numbers, which are huge, and they're only growing. In 2012, the average 18 to 44-year-old consumer was watching 6 minutes of video a day on the go. By 2017, that number had leapt to about 40 minutes, and last year, it was nearly 80 minutes. And as 5G ramps up network speeds, viewers are only going to want more. So we started to wonder, what if we could tell movie-caliber stories with the power of this new technology? What if we created stories that we optimize for viewing? What if we could tell stories that we optimize for viewing on the go? How could we change and improve the experience of watching video entertainment on our phones? Nobody likes to stop a show randomly in the middle of an episode and then come back to it minutes or even a few hours later. So how do we tell big stories in quick bites? This idea actually first occurred to me not from film and television, but from literature. And the best example for me is Dan Brown's The Da Vinci Code. For centuries, novels have been told and written in chapters that were between 20 and 40 pages long. And that's because people read about a page a minute, and after 30 minutes, our eyes get tired. Frequently today, people don't have that kind of time, and no author wants readers to stop in the middle of a chapter. So Dan Brown came along and wrote The Da Vinci Code. It's 464 pages long, and it actually has 105 chapters. On average, each chapter was less than 5 pages long. So if you only had 5 minutes, you could read a whole chapter. And I don't think that anyone thought that there was anything lesser about The Da Vinci Code other than the length of its chapters. For different reasons, television writers have been doing the same thing for decades, writing their stories to very specific act breaks that allow for commercial breaks while keeping the audience engaged all the way through. It was by bringing together the grand storytelling that we have come to love in a 2-hour movie with the writing technique of television that we created Quibi, which is short for quick bites. Big stories told in 6 to 10 minute episodes, or Quibis. From the beginning, we have also known that this next mobile era in entertainment will be defined not just by incredible content, but by the platform through which that content is delivered. Now, I know what I know, and maybe more importantly, I actually know what I don't know. And when it came to building the technology platform I imagined would be at the foundation and the heart of this new experience, I needed a partner. And there was no one who was better embodied the best and the brightest of Silicon Valley than my friend and colleague of more than 30 years, Meg Whitman. Please welcome Meg.
Well, thank you, Jeffrey, and good morning. The relationship between Silicon Valley and Hollywood goes to the very roots of both communities. The very first product that Silicon Valley ever produced, the 200B audio oscillator, was used by Walt Disney to create the incredible sound of Fantasia in 1940. And when Disney purchased 8 of those audio oscillators, they gave birth to Hewlett-Packard and the Silicon Valley that we know today. But we believe there's even more potential when creators and inventors work together from the very start. You know, Jeffrey and I see almost everything differently, and that's our superpower. He is a right-brain creative storyteller, and I'm more of a left-brain analytical thinker. And when we work together, the different strengths that we bring from Hollywood and Silicon Valley give us the potential to create something new and powerful. So we set out on a mission to make mobile moments extraordinary. But what does that actually mean? It means creating a technology platform optimized for people on the go and giving them a great entertainment experience in those in-between moments throughout the day. The time you spend waiting for a doctor's appointment, taking a break from work, maybe the time you spent waiting for this keynote to begin. And so from day one, we wanted to make clear that we are creating a mobile-only platform. Why? Because we're not shrinking TV onto phones. We're creating something new, the very first entertainment technology platform optimized for mobile viewing with quick bite content created by Hollywood's top talent. Think about this. Tomorrow, it will be 13 years to the day since Steve Jobs introduced the iPhone to the world. Stop for just a moment and consider how much your life has changed since that day. We've gone from T9 texting and phone calls to a world where the answer to every question imaginable is just a few taps away. A world where you're never without a comprehensive map of every interstate and every country road. A world where you can shoot a beautiful video of your daughter blowing out her birthday candles and send it to the grandparents on the other side of the planet in just seconds. And yet, With all of this incredible innovation, our current mobile video options present programs that seem to be made for the television in your living room and then later shrunk down for the screen on your phone. So the first question we asked when we started Quibi was, what would it look like not to put TV on a phone, but to build a platform that gives creators access to everything that a phone has to offer? When we look back at the great leaps forward in entertainment, what we often see is the initial attempts at using a new technology aren't anything like the ones that last. For example, when television made its debut, creators had no idea how to take full advantage of the new platform. Some early television shows simply featured announcers reading from radio scripts into the camera. And that's similar to what's happened so far with mobile viewing. Television on phones, just like we once put radio on TV. We believe we've barely explored all the other capabilities of our mobile devices and how they can transform storytelling. So how could we make your mobile moments extraordinary and delightful by thinking just beyond a screen and audio? How can the interactivity of the touchscreen, or the camera, or the GPS, or even the gyroscope affect a story? What would it be like to watch a thriller that knows what time it is? Or a scary story that knows if the lights are out? You know, one moment that brought this to life for me was when Steven Spielberg said to us that he was thinking about making a scary show that could only be watched after dark. When Steven asked, could we do that? The engineers in the room responded, well, since your phones know what time it is, where you are, and what time the sun goes down, yes, we can do that. The episodes can unlock just as it gets dark, and the virtual film can melt away right before your eyes when the sun comes up in the morning. And with that, Steven Spielberg's After Dark was born. Since our goal is script-to-screen innovation, this was the moment it became clear that we needed to make space for creators and engineers to be in the same conversation. Consider for a moment how shows are traditionally created. A script is written, producers come on board, talent in front of the camera and behind the camera join the project. The show is then shot, edited, and color-corrected, and the output is dropped on a shared file server. Only later it's picked up and broadcast or streamed by an entirely new technical team with no connection to the project that came before. The creative team is never even in the same room with the technical team, let alone given the chance to brainstorm about what technology can enable in their stories. At Quibi, we have completely upended this model, and we've been having these integrated technology and creative conversations every day. And that's what's driving the innovations in both our stories and our technology. Now, we're about to give you a sneak peek at the creators who are working with us, the features they've spurred us to build, and the content that it's inspired. And we'd like to start at the foundation, talking with some of the people who are building the Quibi platform and the creators who are using that platform to tell their stories. So let me welcome to the stage Tom Conrad, Quibi's Chief Product Officer.
When Edison Labs invented the first motion picture camera in 1892, they didn't consult movie directors because, well, there weren't any movies yet. The technology came first, and then the creators found possibilities in it that the inventors never even dreamed of. But as Meg said, what makes Quibi unique is our approach to building our product, knocking down the walls between platform and content, and creating a true partnership between technology and creative. What I'd like to talk to you about next is something entirely new that resulted from these conversations. We experience the world in landscape. As I look out at all of you in the audience today, I see you across this huge, wide expanse. But when we hold things, like my phone or even a bottle of water, we tend to hold them in, well, let's call it portrait. Historically, filmmakers have projected their craft on wider and wider screens to fill more and more of our world with theirs. I mean, look at this beast behind me. While at the same time, phone makers have made their screens taller and taller and taller so you can see more and still get your hand around the device. This means that as I'm walking to catch a ride, I hold my phone in portrait, but when I sit down and have both hands available, I'm happier to watch in landscape. But with phones shifting back and forth from portrait to landscape, and cinema presented in landscape alone, product designers have faced a lose-lose scenario. Ignore filmmaking history or ignore user behavior. To tackle this challenge, we've invented a new experience and technology that we call turnstile. With turnstile, you move at will between full screen portrait and full screen landscape. This has required engineering breakthroughs in streaming and user experience. And at the same time, it's opened up an entirely new creative canvas. So, without further ado, this is turnstile.
Most of what I understand Corsetti to be, flour and water, flour, water, and olive oil, flour, water, and salt. But Gabriella has a very modern mindset. She understands life is life, and people do what they want. In the decade plus that I've been doing this, that's like revolutionary.
Thank you. As you can see, video on Quibi is big, beautiful, and full screen no matter how you're holding your phone. I hold the phone as I see fit, and the creator's vision fills the screen just as they intended. This creates an intimate connection with a show like Shape of Pasta that's unlike anything you've ever seen before. Now, as we created Turnstile, we thought the real questions would be artistic ones. Quibi is committed to creating great visual content with post-production that's precisely calibrated to the mobile viewing experience. But the seasoned directors we're working with have spent their careers working in landscape, not portrait. Would it be possible for them to film big, epic shots in a different format? It turns out the answer is yes, as you'll see in this clip by 30 Ninjas, Sar Klein, and director Doug Lyman.
God, I hate the internet.
How could you hate the internet? It's like the greatest invention of the 21st century.
Yeah, it's also how my kids found out there are thousands of hamsters buried alive because they're not really dead, they're just hibernating.
Don't just f***ing stand there! Keep digging!
Hey, watch your mouth. Can you believe her?
Look at this incredible master shot at the end, with our entire cast featured in a one clever moment that works equally well in landscape or portrait. Now, let's look at a short clip from one of our shows, Don't Look Deeper. Here, Catherine Hardwick captures the action in an incredible panning shot in both portrait and landscape. But the most remarkable things happened when we put Turnstile into the hands of creators with the invitation to use the technique as they saw fit. For example, I want to show you a short thriller called Nest, where directors Nelson DeCastro and Zach Wechter play with the environment of the phone itself. To set this clip up, we start with a young woman home alone when a stranger rings her Nest doorbell. Since we live much of our lives in our phones these days, when viewed in portrait, the story plays out as a series of interactions that we can watch on our young protagonist's phone. So, we open then in portrait, showing her view of the Nest app.
Hello?
The fun thing, though, is when you rotate your phone to landscape, the action proceeds as in a traditional thriller.
Got a package here?
Could you just leave it on the doorstep?
And when you rotate back to portrait, you see her phone again.
You know what? I'll come back. You have a good one.
Concerned, she attempts a video call to her father. Who doesn't answer, but responds with a text message saying he'll call her later. Unfortunately, later isn't soon enough, because soon her Nest says there's motion at the front door again. Now, it's one thing for me to talk about how creators are responding to Quibi, but it's quite another to hear from the creators themselves. Zach Wechter is one of the creators behind Nest, and he's directing the Nest-inspired thriller Wireless for Quibi. In Wireless, actor Ty Sheridan plays a self-obsessed college student who is stranded in the Colorado mountains after he crashes his car, and his only hope of escape is his quickly dying phone. Please welcome Zach Wechter and Ty Sheridan. So thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you.
Now, Zach, Nest is such an amazing example of the creative things that can be done with Turnstile. Can you tell us a bit about where the idea came from and what it was like to work with Quibi to bring it to life?
Yeah. So the idea for Nest was driven largely by the work my mobile filmmaking collective, Pickbock, and I have been doing, designing projects specifically for phones. With Nest, we wanted to experiment with this dual asset perspective and explore what rotating the phone to tell one singular story from two perspectives could look like. As you saw, if you watch the scene holding your phone horizontally, you see a sort of traditional cinematic perspective. And when you rotate your phone vertically, the character's phone takes over your own. Seeing a character through the Nest camera was my partner Nelson's idea and seemed like an interesting way to explore a traditional dialogue scene in a totally new format.
So, how does it change the way you think about storytelling when you start to allow the phone to become a kind of character in the story?
I think that our phones are both new characters and new settings in our lives. Our phones are extensions of ourselves, central to the ways in which we communicate as individuals, but they're also spaces we inhabit. They're the place in which we experience so much of our relationships and where real moments of self-discovery now take place. So, for us, being able to tell stories set largely in the online world and designed specifically to be watched on phones, it's really just a reflection of the real lives our audiences now live every day.
So, Ty, what's it like as an actor to work on a project like this, like Wireless?
Well, with every job, new challenges present themselves, and specific to this project, we had the challenge of telling the story in a dual perspective, which really was so different than anything I've ever experienced before, and it kept me on my toes.
And is that what drew you to the project?
Yeah, for me, this was an absolute dream job because it really is breaking new ground. It's pushing the boundaries of technology, and it's embracing a device that each one of us here in this room have such an intimate relationship with. And that idea was extremely attractive, and to be a part of something that's the first of its kind was just an opportunity that I couldn't pass up.
Now, Zach, your collective actually printed a special 3D rig in order to shoot the portrait portions of the film, the ones where the film's characters take over the phone of the viewer. Can you talk a little bit about how that worked?
Yeah, so this is Pickpocket's tri-phone rig, and it uses three phones to capture our character's phone screen while simultaneously recording the perspectives of their phone's forward and rear-facing cameras. When we intercut these tracks and view them on a phone vertically, It creates a new presence-driven format meant to place viewers in both the digital and physical perspective of our character's phone.
Absolutely incredible. Now, Ty, I know you've brought a clip. Do you want to set this up for us?
Yeah, sure. So in this scene, my character Andy is on his way to a New Year's Eve party where he's hoping to win back his ex-girlfriend. But before he arrives, he loses control of his car, he skids off a road, and he comes to a rest, hanging by a thread over a deep ravine while a blizzard rages outside. While he waits for help to arrive, he scrolls on his phone when he discovers a disturbing image of his girlfriend on Instagram.
Right, let's see it.
No. You were right, man. I should have told you the truth. Period. When did Dana tell you? Question mark.
As you can see, Quibi is built on a groundbreaking collaboration between creators and engineers. The product team at Quibi could never have imagined the creativity our directors would bring to this project. And our creators couldn't have told their stories without the innovations of the Quibi platform. We could only accomplish this leap forward in both technology and storytelling together. Thank you so much for helping us on this journey and coming to be with us at CES.
Thank you.
Our pleasure. Thanks, Tom.
Now, having a vision for the platform we wanted to build was one thing, but building it from the ground up was quite another. So let me bring to the stage Rob Post, our Chief Technology Officer, to fill in the other half of this story.
When we started building Quibi, we created two engineering tracks. One was prototypes, big breakthrough ideas, mobile experiences that would differentiate Quibi from the rest. The other track was building the platform, all the basic functionality needed for a premium video distribution platform. The ultimate goal was to create the stability and performance of a great platform, coupled with the innovation and differentiation of these new ideas. Tom and I have been working closely together with our teams to turn Quibi's unique ideas into reality. On the platform side, that means building something truly native to the mobile environment. And with mobile viewing, the problems might seem simple, but the solutions are actually quite complex. Take Turnstile. Tom just showed you the solution we're launching in the product on April 6th. The usability problem it solves is easy to articulate. Users want to be able to move seamlessly between portrait and landscape while watching full-screen video. We needed to solve both technical and creative composition challenges so you can experience the full story regardless of how you hold the phone. Our solution needed to eliminate FOMO, the fear that you're missing out in either orientation. We started with the notion that perhaps we could just crop to a landscape video in portrait as the user turned their phone. And as you can see, this quickly falls apart. Without understanding the focus of storytelling on screen, the cropping of the image quickly interferes with effective storytelling. We considered using pan and scan solutions or using AI and machine learning to choose the best framing And we actually had some success with these techniques. However, it was really clear that we could never always deliver a premium experience. The best storytelling could only come about if the creators owned the composition, the edit in each orientation. And this was a breakthrough. It led us to require that each episode on Quibi be delivered with two edits, one optimized for portrait and one optimized for landscape viewing. The question then became how to transition seamlessly between these two edits with great performance and reliability, even when streaming over a mobile network. We experimented with many different implementations, and we found that the best user experience was obtained by stitching the two edits together, encoding and packaging them as one, and delivering them both to the phone. This entirely new technique forms the foundation of our patent portfolio. We're also creating an experience that works across mobile viewing environments in any network conditions. Our video delivery will give you the best quality of experience whether you're on Wi-Fi, 3G, or completely offline. To achieve the best quality of service in video playback, we look to the company that's been doing it best on a global scale. Google, through YouTube, has been perfecting mobile viewing at scale for more than a decade. So let me bring to the stage President of Industry Product and Solutions for Google Cloud, Tariq Shaukat. It's good to see you. Thanks for joining us.
Great to be here.
Google has been an invaluable part of the Quibi journey from the very beginning, and we are partnering on a number of fronts. Why is Google so interested in this space?
Well, the reality is that Google and Jeffrey have been talking about short-form video and working together on the idea that eventually evolved into Quibi for more than 6 years. And there are so many areas in which we are collaborating to bring this vision to life. The Google Cloud team is supporting the back end of Quibi. Our AI and machine learning capabilities are helping drive auto-discovery of content on the platform. The Pixel team is working to optimize the mobile viewing experience. And of course, Quibi is one of the first media companies to take advantage of our optimized CDN capabilities.
You mentioned that Quibi will be one of the first companies to use this sort of innovation. Google and YouTube have been focused on the delivery of mobile video at scale for a long time. Our ability to take advantage of that is a true differentiator. What would you say would be the key differentiations of that CDN?
Well, let's start with what we mean by delivering streaming video at scale. As you said, we have done this for over a decade with services that power YouTube, and we're excited to take this expertise to drive some incredible advantages to your platform. I think one of the most important things to note is that our infrastructure has unique capabilities like low latency content delivery that have been truly optimized for video. We have cloud regions, each with massive computing capabilities in more than 20 locations globally, all connected through our advanced high-performance network and content servers in a huge number of points of presence around the globe. So all of this helps bring unique, personalized content closer to users and can really help empower the differentiated experience that Quibi is producing. It can also help provide Quibi with and its users, most importantly, with a smoother watching experience and a smoother downloading experience, especially when powering innovations like Turnstile.
Really impressive. What would you say are the biggest impacts these capabilities have for our viewers?
Well, when it comes to streaming video, of course, speed and latency are always concerns. Quibi is a premium platform, and as we've discussed from the beginning, it is really mission critical that viewers have a seamless experience. There can't be any buffering, even in low bandwidth locations. Our network has been purpose-built for that kind of high-quality streaming video delivery, unlike other networks that have been more built for general-purpose content delivery.
Wow. Google has been such an important partner in getting us to where we are today. What makes Google so interested in partnering with Quibi?
Well, to be honest, we love what you're doing. The idea of creating a premium platform designed for mobile that features movie quality content, we think is really game changing and very cool.
Super, thank you. Thanks for being here today and sharing a little bit about what our companies are doing together.
Thank you.
Now, creating Turnstile and building for scale aren't the only hard problems that we've been working on here at Quibi. Another fundamental issue with mobile viewing is simply finding something to watch fast. Quibi's use case is on-the-go moments, those times when we've got just 5 or 10 minutes throughout the day. We don't want you spending the majority of that time just trying to find something. So we thought about what people actually do today to find content in their in-between moments, and they scroll through their social media or news feeds. The Quibi feed is how users will find what's right for them, the best of what's available for each user every day. Our goal is to get users to the right content in the blink of an eye. Since all of our shows are original, we start tagging metadata when shows are in development. Each video is tagged by the creators and Quibi content specialists. Our machine learning models will learn and improve with every action taken on Quibi. We'll look at what you like, when you watch it, to give you exactly what you want at this time of day, at this very moment. Once users have found the right content or it's found for them, we want to make sure they can see it just as quickly. Now, we recognize that not every on-the-go moment has access to a network connection. So Quibi offers downloads to all of our customers in both ad-supported and ad-free tiers. We'll also be using smart caching to make sure the stream plays under intermittent networking conditions. We've made gestures simpler for mobile viewing, including a vertical scrubber that allows viewers to scroll quickly through content, even in portrait mode. And if you're a lefty, we have you covered. We've also introduced the concept of segments. For news briefs, sports highlights, or late-night recaps, we're tagging each video with metadata that denotes the start of a segment in the lineup. So, if you'd like to catch up on last night's NBA action, The Replay, our sports show created exclusively for Quibi by ESPN, has what you need. You start the show, pull up the scrubber segment picker, and jump directly to the latest Lakers highlight. We are obsessing over mobile video like no one else to bring you moments of delight while using Quibi. These are just a few examples, a small sneak peek into what's available at launch. Having partners like Google have been critical to the development of our technology platform, but our partners on the advertising side of the house have been just as important as we thought about how to build the advertising platform of the future. Let me welcome Meg back to the stage to tell you more.
So as Rob said, Quibi doesn't just offer creators a new way to tell stories, it offers advertisers a new way as well. A premium, brand-safe platform that targets the millennial audience during their lean-forward, on-the-go moments. And it's our ambition to create the best mobile advertising ecosystem in the world. The fact that we curate all of our content so carefully at Quibi is key for advertisers, because it means that their messages are always going to appear alongside brand-appropriate premium content. No surprises. And we're creating content with the millennial audience in mind, the stars and stories that they love, and we're delivering it to them in a way they actually watch, in quick bite chapters on the go. And we have an amazing lineup of the world's biggest and most forward-thinking advertisers joining us at launch, including Anheuser-Busch, Discover, General Mills, Google, Procter & Gamble, Pepsi, Progressive, Taco Bell, T-Mobile, and Walmart. So thanks to all these incredible brands and our agency partners, including Dentsu, Omnicom Media Group, Publicis, and WPP, we've sold out our entire first-year advertising inventory of $150 million. So our advertisers see this new platform as a truly unique way to engage with their consumers and tell their brand stories. And we will offer advertisers a variety of ways to engage consumers. Some will leverage non-skippable 6, 10, or 15-second pre-roll ads that are not in pods and don't interrupt the content. Others will make ads the way our creators make content, delivering big stories in quick bites, so that they can tell a continuous story. For example, a 60-second story could be delivered in 4 15-second episodes that the users view as they move through different content on the platform. Our advertising environment will have a much lower ad load than just about any other service, just 2.5 minutes per hour, and that compares to broadcast television, where you have an average of 17.5 minutes of advertising per hour. Our goal is an uncluttered experience for both our advertisers and our users. You know, at Quibi, we have seen that innovation inspires innovation again and again, and we're seeing the same thing happen with our advertising partners. One of our launch partners, PepsiCo, has always been an advertising pioneer, a company that moves at the speed of culture with their brands and their campaigns. And today, they are once again breaking new ground with a brand new way to connect with consumers through our turnstile technology. And I'm thrilled to welcome to the stage Adam Harder, Pepsi Senior Vice President of Sports, Media, and Entertainment, to talk about how the platform has inspired Pepsi and what they're creating in response to it. Welcome, Adam Harder.
Thank you.
So thanks for being here. We're just thrilled that you're one of our launch partners.
Thank you for having me at such an historic occasion.
Yeah. Well, our companies have been excited to partner, and we just thought you were perfect for us. But why did this make sense for Pepsi?
Well, more so than ever before, consumers' expectations are that brands will start to anticipate emerging trends, these cultural shifts, these moments that move us. And their expectations is that brands will show up there, and they'll show up there in ways that are impactful, that are authentic, and importantly, in ways that are non-invasive. So for a company like PepsiCo, with brands like Pepsi and Mountain Dew, Doritos, and Gatorade, we're constantly striving to keep those brands at the forefront of culture and continuously looking for opportunities to innovate in how we tell those brand stories.
Well, we're excited to be working with you because you've got such a history of innovation. And I wonder if you could talk about what Quibi innovations are most exciting to you as an advertiser and to your creative executives.
Sure. For us, the ability to test and learn on a new platform that's been built from the ground up for mobile, it presents several ways for us to explore new approaches to creative and, I think, also audience engagement. I think, like most advertisers, we found it challenging to reach millennials during that on-the-go moment. And that's really Quibi's sweet spot that you're focused on. So once we find them on your platform, what we love about the fact that you're offering this to us is that they're full-screen ads, that it's an uncluttered environment, and that your ad load is the lowest of any other platform out there right now. So we have confidence that once we reach the audience, we're actually going to be able to capture their attention and tell our stories in a different way.
And I guess, you know, maybe most appealing, you're building this with us together. You know, one of the things we said to our advertisers is help us build a great advertising platform.
Yes, so what we love about that is you are building the Quibi platform in partnership with advertisers. Yeah. And so what that allows us to do is shape the future of advertising on the platform with you. And I think our teams have had great conversations already. I feel like together we are helping to build on those strengths of Quibi that we talked about. And you're making us better as advertisers, because as you innovate, you inspire us to innovate as well. And maybe one good example of that is with our taste and refreshment advertising. And our taste and refreshment advertising is essentially those ads that you see that are designed specifically to remind people how delicious and refreshing our beverages are. So these are the ads where there are close-up shots of the product being poured over ice, and we're romancing the bubbles and the condensation and the fizz, and just reminding people that they taste great. But through your turnstile technology, what you've allowed us to do is take a traditional ad format like that and play around, have a little fun, and literally turn it on its head to make it more engaging for consumers. So for us, we've been able to do that for brand Pepsi, and I think we can take a look right now at our Pepsi turnstile ad.
Great. Fabulous. You did not disappoint. Well, good. All right. So I think you have one more ad that you want to talk to us a little bit about.
Yeah, the other thing as marketers that we're really excited about is contextual relevance.
Right.
And it's something that you guys are offering that we're really energized about. Context is so powerful. And we believe the unique opportunity that Quibi provides is allowing us to connect our brands to those Hollywood creators that our consumers are already passionate about. And we see the role of our brands is setting the stage for those fellow storytellers on the Quibi platform. And because of the control that Quibi gives us, we can build ads that work seamlessly with the content that they introduce. And so what we'd like to do is show, this is the very first turnstile ad we actually ever produced, and it's for the Mountain Dew brand. It was in partnership with Scott Weintraub and the Quibi show Skirt with Offset, who we're also a big fan of.
Yep.
And if you think about it, if you're a car enthusiast, for example, and you're excited to go consume this content, if there's going to be a brand message introduced, you want that to be done in a way that's interesting, that's authentic, in a way that that viewer will appreciate. And that's what we strive to do with this ad.
Let's take a look. Great, let's take a look at it. Really great.
So, look, I think both of our companies are so passionate about innovating. We're so passionate about reaching who we call the unreachables.
Yeah.
But at its core, I think we're both about telling great stories, and that's the basis for a great partnership. So thank you for letting us be part of this journey with you.
Well, thank you for being a pioneer with us. This is really great stuff. Thanks so much, Adam.
Thank you.
Take care.
Now, in addition to our advertising partners, Quibi recently announced that T-Mobile will be our telco partner at launch. So let me welcome T-Mobile's next CEO, Mike Seifert, to the stage.
Great.
Well, thank you for joining us today.
Well,
we're so excited to have you.
Thanks for having me. I'm excited to be here, particularly first thing in the morning after a Las Vegas night out. So on behalf of the crowd, I want to thank you for that.
Well, T-Mobile is one of our most important partners, and I'm wondering if you could talk a little bit about how T-Mobile and Quibi are going to partner together.
You know, I think we've been excited to partner with Quibi since it was a twinkle in Jeffrey's eye several years ago. So we're going to go big. You know, we're going to go big. We're going to bundle it with our services. We're going to bring it to our 68 million customers. And there's a reason for that. You know, our customers have an insatiable demand for what Quibi is going to bring. Mobile video today is the biggest payload on our network. 57% of our network consumption is mobile video, and 80% of that mobile video is short-form content, things like YouTube, Instagram, TikTok, etc. And so the idea to bring that storytelling to a higher quality and have the first ever media service that's designed for mobile is something our customers are ready for, and we're excited to be a part of it.
Well, one of the things that we were excited about your company is we think you're an incredible marketing organization. I mean, maybe the best, one of the best marketers in the country. And so just tell us a little bit about how you're thinking about marketing this partnership and what, you know, what you can bring to bear.
Well, one of the advantages that T-Mobile has is we have an established relationship with 68 million customers who've already demonstrated that they want to get their media from us, that they want us to help them with those choices, and we're going to bring it to them. We're going to bring it to them through tens of thousands of retail reps at thousands and thousands of stores. Tens of millions of our customers have our mobile app and can learn about Quibi through the mobile app. Our groundbreaking thank you program, not a loyalty program, a thank you program called T-Mobile Tuesdays, is enjoyed by millions and millions of people. It's going to be a great way for people to learn about Quibi and so many more ways. We're going to be an advertiser on the platform, and we're excited about how Quibi represents a new way of storytelling for advertisers as well. So that'll be a way that customers learn about.
Yeah, we were so impressed when you told us about the results of T-Mobile Tuesdays. I mean, it's really, it's such an innovation.
Thank you.
Yeah. So why do you think these two brands are such a great fit together?
Well, I'll start by saying that T-Mobile's customers are insatiable users of mobile video. And, you know, as I said, and it's a big part of our history, we were the first to allow free streaming of data for mobile video back in 2015 with our Binge On program, which is probably the most famous of all of our Uncarrier moves. Later, we led the way into Unlimited, which is the industry standard today, which is a big enabler for mobile video. In 2017, we became the first provider to bundle a leading media service with wireless, with our Netflix on Us on Carrier Move. And today, millions of customers get their Netflix through T-Mobile and enjoy that. But this represents a new way to tell stories and a new way to bring mobile video to life for our customers. So, you know, look, we're an innovative company. Quibi is the most innovative thing to come to storytelling in a long time. So we obviously are made for each other. But, you know, as we think about it strategically, I'll say that our general view at T-Mobile is that all content and communications of all kinds are moving from their former linear formats and traditional formats to the internet. And the internet itself is going mobile. And so Quibi's the next big thing, and we're delighted to be a part of it.
Oh, you're crying. That's fantastic. Now, the other thing that we were super excited about was your cutting edge and leading position on 5G. We think 5G can be a game changer, but you know much more about it than we do. So talk a little bit about how you're approaching 5G and what you think it will do for consumers.
One thing I'll say is it's here.
Yeah?
Finally, after all those years of hype and talk, on December 2nd, T-Mobile became the first company to launch 5G nationwide, reaching more than 200 million people as of December 2nd of last year. And that's just a different strategy. Our approach to 5G is that 5G should be something that everybody gets. It should be nationwide. It should be, you know, today it's in 5,000 cities and towns already and rapidly growing. And that's in contrast to how our competitors think about it. There are those out there who are breathlessly announcing that they have some seating sections of some NFL stadiums
right.
covered or some portions of some cities. That's not our mindset. We think innovators like Quibi are going to need to rely on a 5G connection being everywhere. And that's something that we have today that we'll be expanding through the year. And this is big stuff. Think about it. Over the next couple of years or a few years, particularly as we're able to bring 5G, not just broadly as I described, but deeply through the new T-Mobile, through our merger with Sprint, we're going to be able to give people connections that are not just 30 megabits per second like today's connections. They're upwards of 500 megabits per second. And you think about how that will unleash creativity. Jeffrey talked a little bit earlier about how innovations have changed storytelling. And this is an innovation that we're on the doorstep of. This kind of capacity and low latency will further change how Quibi unfolds over the next few years and how people consume stories and how they entertain themselves. And, you know, I love the interplay of technology and how it'll be an enabler for an innovator like Quibi.
And I remember when we first met, you said Quibi could be the perfect use case for 5G.
Absolutely. And, you know, and tens of millions of people are going to have a chance to experience that because of how we'll bring it to T-Mobile's customers from day one. And we're excited that the launch is upon us.
Yes, yes, after a lot of planning. Well, listen, thank Mike Seifert for coming and helping us do this. And good luck with the continued rollout of 5G. You're the best.
Thanks, Meg.
Thanks.
Cheers.
Thanks, everybody.
So now I'd like to welcome Jeffrey back to the stage to talk about some of the extraordinary creators who are working on the platform and the unique content that they've been creating for Quibi.
So if you now you've actually heard from Meg and from Tom and from Rob, we actually set out to tell Hollywood caliber stories in a whole new way on a platform that it has become completely ubiquitous, which is the mobile phone. Our vision was storytelling in 5 to 10 minute chapters that fit perfectly into every moment of your day. We aim to give you big stories in quick bites. Typically, when you start a streaming service, the conversation is about acquiring libraries of content that already exist. But because there's never been a mobile streaming service like Quibi before, we've had to make every piece of content from scratch, and a lot of it. In the first year following our launch, we will roll out more than 175 new original shows and 8,500 quick bites of content. And it will range from comedies and dramas to dating shows and news, all made by the biggest names in Hollywood. We realize that not every in-between moment in your day calls for the same kind of entertainment, so our approach to the content is meant to assume that we have something for every moment. We're creating three categories of content that give our audience very different kinds of entertainment experiences depending on what they are looking for. Our goal is to inform, to entertain, and to inspire you. So, the first category is our movies that are told in chapters. We're creating more than 35 of them this year, each told in episodes that are 7 to 10 minutes in length. And they feature many of Hollywood's biggest names, both in front of and behind the camera. And let me just share a few of them with you. From Academy Award winner Pete Farrelly comes a comedy starring Dave Franco and Bill Murray about a young man with a troubled past who has to learn to live in the now. Anton Fuqua's hashtag Free Rayshon is an intense hostage-taking drama set in New Orleans that stars Stephon James and Lawrence Fishburne. Kiefer Sutherland and Boyd Holbrook are starring in The Fugitive, and it's a brand new take on this classic story. Sam Raimi is working on a horror anthology series that tells the scariest story from each state, and it's called 50 States of Fright. Catherine Hardwicke, who you saw a little clip from here, directed a futuristic AI thriller starring Don Cheadle and Emily Mortimer and a fantastic new actress, Helena Howard, who realizes after an accident, she's not human, she's a robot. Lorne Michaels and Seth Meyers together are producing a show with Saturday Night Live's Paula Pell. Inspired by Murder, She Wrote, she is writing and starring in a comedic crime procedural with an all-star cast of guests, suspects, and victims who keep dying in comedic ways in this quaint little town. Kevin Hart stars in the comedy action scene where he's on a quest to land the action movie role of a lifetime, and you guess it, he keeps getting rejected for the role. So, from Steven Spielberg to Academy Award winner Guillermo del Toro, we have made many of the best storytellers making movies in chapters, and we actually have a lot more to come. Now, let's move to our second category, which is our episodic and unscripted series and documentaries. Across the board, unscripted series and docs will top more than 120 shows in the first year alone. Food, fashion, travel, animals, cars, build, music, sports, comedy, talk, variety. You get it. We've got it all done in 10 minutes or less with many of the biggest celebrities in the world. With so much star power, we call this must-see Quibi. Chrissy Teigen plays a modern-day Judge Judy in Chrissy's Court, where the tagline is, "There is no claim that is too small." When she tweeted that she was doing the show, more than 3,000 people submitted their claim for her to arbitrate in 24 hours. Actor and racing enthusiast Idris Elba is going head-to-head with the professional driver Ken Block to prove who's the best stunt driver in Elba versus Block. We're bringing back the popular MTV shows Punked and Singled Out. For dog lovers, we have Barkitecture, a show about extravagant dog houses. Think cribs for dogs. And for the food lovers, we have Dismantled, a high-octane cooking competition hosted by Tytus Burgess that actually will literally blow your socks off. Our shows made for mobile also include compelling docuseries. Lena Waithe looks at sneaker culture and its impact on society. Sasha Velour, as she prepares for the biggest drag showcase of her life. And an exploration into the societal standards of beauty and how they develop, starring Tyra Banks. Now, in addition to bringing our users the best in Hollywood storytelling, Quibi also offers our viewers something we call daily essentials. The world today is overwhelmed by video information, but it's not curated, and it certainly isn't convenient. Our ambition is to do both. Our daily essentials will deliver to you the day's news and information from the best sources and valued brands in a unique format that can actually only be found on Quibi. We're partnering with some of the most trusted names in news and information to reimagine how news can be delivered for the millennial generation, telling you everything you need to know and why it matters. And it's all delivered in 5 to 6 minute quick bites, so you can stay up to speed on weather, news, sports, you name it, even horoscope. NBC News will produce 2 national news shows every morning and 2 every evening. Made exclusively for Quibi, they will feature dedicated editorial, hosts, and correspondents and take advantage of NBC News' global resources. The BBC, which is the most trusted news brand for American millennials, will host a global news show for us at 12 noon each day. TMZ will deliver unique and edgy celebrity news twice a day. Telemundo will offer 2 shows featuring news and entertainment reflecting Latinx perspectives for our bilingual
and bicultural audience. We have a gaming show produced by Polygon that will give the esports adjacent audience the news they need to know. We're partnering with the Weather Channel for national and hyperlocal forecasts, leveraging their unique augmented reality technology 7 days a week. But Daily Essentials isn't only about news. We're also about curating a wide range of lifestyle programming, including entertainment, pop, and culture. The Rachel Hollis Show is one of Quibi's unique take on the daily talk show. We also have a meditation show called The Daily Chill, and which uses ASMR sound and a very unique video technique, which is scientifically proven to help you relax. Trust me, it worked on me. I'm pretty sure it's going to work on all of you. My personal favorite, though, is last night's late night. There are 22 late night shows, and there's just no way that you can keep up on all of this amazing talent. So our late night roundup show will give you the smartest monologues, the best interviews, and the funniest sketches from the world of late night, all in under 6 minutes. So as you can see, we're setting out to deliver something for everyone and also something for every moment. Hollywood and Silicon Valley are all about reinvention, relevance, and creating something new. Creators love experimenting, and they love being a part of the next big thing. So when we opened our doors with this new way and opportunity to tell stories on mobile, they quickly embraced it. It's hard to believe that it was less than 18 months ago that we first announced the Quibi to the world, and I actually could not be more proud that in that very short amount of time, this incredible wall of entertainment and many, many more have agreed to be a part of it and to help us build it. And so with that, welcome back my partner, Meg.
Thank you, Jeffrey. So I hope that you'll agree we are building something truly unique at Quibi. By bringing creators and technologists into the same conversation, both sides have helped each other reimagine what's possible. As Tom and Rob showed you, we are developing a technology platform that is optimized for viewing on the go. With built-in intelligence, you'll find the right content for every moment of your day, instantly. And we are partnering with industry geniuses like Google and T-Mobile to ensure that content is delivered seamlessly regardless of network bandwidth conditions. And we've developed unique features like Turnstile to reimagine the mobile viewing experience. And as Jeffrey laid out, we have truly unique premium quality programming across all three categories of content. And we're not only delivering quality, but as important for our customers, we are delivering quantity. Every day, we will deliver one episode of our movies told in chapters, 5 episodes of our episodic and unscripted series and documentaries, and 25 daily essentials. That's more than 3 hours of premium original content every day, 52 weeks a year, nearly 35% more than any television network delivers during their primetime schedule. And when we launch on April 6th, you'll get it all for just $4.99 a month ad-supported and $7.99 a month ad-free. But you do not have to wait until April to get involved. For behind-the-scenes information, visit Quibi.com and sign up to become a Quibi Insider. You'll get exclusive updates on news and show content and much more. Now, we have shown you an awful lot from up here on the stage today. And it's one thing to see Turnstile on this enormous screen, but it's quite another to hold it in your hands and see it for yourself. So we'd like to invite all of you to the Balboa Ballroom in the Park MGM Conference Center following today's presentation to get a chance to experience Turnstile for yourself, courtesy of Google and Pixel. The demo is right here, a 5-minute walk inside the Park MGM. And please look for our brand ambassadors in purple as you exit the theater, and they will have directions to the Balboa Ballroom.
So we are living through the next great leap forward in entertainment technology, the age of mobile entertainment. And we are at the very beginning of exploring how this new medium can be used to create amazing entertainment, unlike anything that has been seen in film and television. What happens when we bring the best of Hollywood together with the best of Silicon Valley? We write a whole new kind of story, and we can't wait for you to see it. Thank you very much.
The future is in your hands. Quibi.
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 Stands for quick bites.
Quick bites.
Quick bites.
Big moments.
Big scares.
Big mysteries.
Big emotion.
Big romance.
Big fantasy.
Big laughs.
Big stakes.
Big stars.
Did you catch it?